Students, let's solve question number 6. The question number 6 says that a block of mass 1 kg is placed on a rough inclined plane. That is a rough inclined plane like this. This block is placed over here. At an angle theta is 30 degree with horizontal. This block is connected with a string as shown. So the figure I have not drawn, just I will draw the figure here. This is a string which is connected to this block, and I will suppose place this like that. So this is how the block is connected with the string. If I cut the string, it might fall down, it might slide down, or it may not, depending on the situation that we are going to analyze. The block is connected with the string as shown in figure if mu s is 3 by 4. Mu s is the coefficient of static friction for the two bodies in contact, the block and the inclined surface. Find the tension in the string. I say that suppose the tension in the string is T. T is the tension in the string. So you have to find the tension T. Now, we have to first understand basic concept. As in the previous example, we saw that in an inclined plane, if I place a block at the angle of repose, it starts sliding. If it starts sliding, and if that condition, if the block is connected to the string, then string will have a tension, because the block moves, wants to move down. So therefore, it will create a tension in the string. Just like, suppose I take a block and just tie the block, one end of the string to the block and other, I hold it. Then I see that the block is suspended like so. If I release the string, the block will fall down. That means what? That there is a tension in the string, because the block has a tendency to move down, and the string is preventing it from falling down with creating a tension. That means if there is no tendency of the block to go down, there will be no tension. Now in the inclined plane, if I place at the angle of repose, then the block has a tendency to move down. So in that case, the tension will be created. If the angle, suppose the angle of repose is 45 degree, so if the block is placed at 45 degree, then also there will be tension in the string. If I place it below 45, that is suppose 30 degree, then block has the friction is sufficient enough to prevent its motion. So when friction is sufficient, you don't need any other external force like tension in the string to hold it back, because friction is enough to prevent it. So in that case, there is no tension. So first of all, we have to find the minimum angle at which the block starts sliding down. In the question, it is given 30 degree. We don't know whether at angle of 30 degree starts sliding, because mu is given. And we know that tan theta is mu s that we found last time. The angle of repose, the tangent of this angle of repose is equal to the coefficient of static friction. This implies that tan of 30 degree is equal to, sorry, this tan of this theta is for this case, and I have to find the angle of repose. So I'll write this is another angle, say angle of repose. I will consider theta dash, suppose. So from here I want to know my angle of repose, not the angle given in the question. So suppose I call it theta dash, then tan theta dash is mu s. From here I'll write tan of theta dash. This is not that. Tan of theta dash equals to mu s, and that is equal to 3 by 4. If tan theta dash is 3 by 4, then what is that theta dash? If I have a triangle like so, I want, suppose this angle is theta dash. In this right hand triangle, this is 3, this is 4, then tan theta dash is 3 by 4 like so, so this will be 5. Tan theta dash 3 by 4 is a very common angle, so tan 3 by 4, then this angle must be 37 degree and this angle must be 53 degree. This is a very common, and this angle is 90 degree. So therefore theta dash is 37 degree. So tan inverse 3 by 4, so theta dash is 37 degree. That means what? This 37 theta dash is called angle of repose. This is the angle of repose. That means if I place this block at an inclination of 37 degree, then it starts sliding down. That means the friction is insufficient to prevent this motion. So it's, while sliding down, there will be a tension in the string. If I, but this block is placed at an angle of 30 degree, which is less than the angle of repose, that means the friction is sufficient enough to prevent this motion. So if it is turned of 30 degree, then the friction that will be acting on it is also just have a look at this. The friction will be acting up, and the component of the force that is acting down is mg sine theta, and this frictional force acting up is Fs, and that Fs comes out to be mg, that m is 1 given in the question, 1 kilogram, and g is, suppose I take 10 and sine of 30, so it is coming out to be 5 newton. So frictional force is 5 newton is sufficient, and it will prevent this, and therefore the tension, there is no requirement of tension in the string, so tension in the string will be 0. You got my point? Tension in the string will be 0, because when the angle is more than angle of the repose, in that case only there will be a tension in the string, because in that case mg corresponding to that theta, sine of theta, will be greater than the limiting force of friction. Therefore, it starts sliding. In that case, there will be tension. In this case, there is no tension. So, tension in the string is 0. So, final answer is zero. Now, if I have to understand a little more about that, let us add one more thing to it. I give it to you as a homework question. Instead of this 30 degree, if it would have been 45 degree, then what would have happened? If I place this situation in an inclination of 45 degree, and that angle is greater than this angle of repose, so in that case I can definitely say the body is sliding down or tries to slide down. In that case tension will be there. In that condition, you try at home and find the tension acting in the string. Just I'll give you a little hint. Find the net force acting downward, that is obviously mg sine of theta. Theta is what? Theta, theta is the angle on which the block is placed. That is, suppose I give you an example of 45 degree, then it is sine 45 degree. What friction will act? Friction will be acting in the upper direction is mu s n, that is limiting force of friction, that is mu s mg cos theta. The difference, and also there will be tension in the string. In that case, there will be tension in the string, because this is greater than that, and that will be tension in the string. Okay, try at home. Thank you.